Hello guys, and welcome back to another all new Assassin's Creed 2. And as you can see, we are back at our uncle's villa. It's me, a Mario. I just love that. Anyway, so where we last left off, because we finally took down that guy, which I totally forgot his name, but we took him down because he was involved in our father's murder trial. And man, we swarmed up in Tuscany and we just like whooped those fools up. So now we on another mission.
And here he is, our campione, Ezio.
Oh, hey, Ezio!
I see you've wasted no time starting the celebration.
And why not? You've done us a great service, Nipote. With Vieri dead, La Toscana will grow quiet once more. Do you know what that means?
Basta lavorare.
Si passa tutto il giorno a bere.
E a puttane. What? It's true.
Come.
I wish I could know Italian. But they don't. Alright.
The Pazzi answer to another. Spaniard.
He is Rodrigo Borgia, one of the most powerful men in all of Europe, and leader of the Templar Order.
Hold up.
Which makes him responsible for the murder of my father and brothers.
Yes, and he will kill you too, given the chance.
Then I must stand against him if I wish to be free. But not until every other Templar has fallen to my blade. Father's list will guide me.
Where will you go next?
Firenze. Francesco de Pazzi will share the fate of his son.
A sensible next step. No doubt he intends evil for the city. All right. That's enough grim talk for one night. I'll be in my study if you need me.
I shall read the letter my uncle gave me.
Did he say Francesca Borgia? Oh my goodness. As in the Borgias. One of the most famous families in Italy. Oh man. I know who the Borgias are. I'm kind of freaking out right now. Because I know who the Borgias are. Oh jeez. This game's going to be awesome. It's going to be I'm going to see some historical people. All right, let us speak to Mario.
Look familiar?
All the codex pages.
Yes, your father managed to find and translate a few before he...
Here.
This is not your father's work. Someone else has translated it.
Leonardo da Vinci, a friend.
Do you see the way the words cross from one page to the next?
There is something underneath it all. Some kind of map. Where is it supposed to lead?
Your father and I managed to make out bits of a prophecy scrawled across these pages. It was written by an assassin like us, who long ago held a piece of Eden. His name was Altair. He spoke of something powerful and ancient hidden beneath the land.
What is it?
What indeed? Solving that little mystery is exactly why we collected these pages.
Then let me help. It's time I take on my father's work. All of it. I start with the page I took from Vieri. Leonardo will decode it for us.
Ben, return here when time permits, and we'll add it to the wall.
Awesome. So he's finally accepted. That he must make sure the Ball of Eden cannot be accepted by the Templars. Alright. Use the map to locate objectives. Okay, yeah, I know how to do that, man. Why you gotta tell me stuff that I already know? Reach the villa's viewpoint.
Mm.
Alright, I think I gotta go back in. Meeting the Borgia. That is something. Okay, I'm 22. Okay. Where is that place at? Tell me I gotta climb up there. Okay, I think I gotta go on the second floor. Okay, I have nothing for that feather chest, so. Reach the villa. Reach the villa's viewpoint. Oh! Well, yeah, didn't I just do that already? I don't know why they're making me do that again. What in the world? It's like it froze every time I went up there like that. Okay, there we go. Yeah, why not do this a second time? Okay. Whatever that is. So, where's the codex at? There it is. Loot it. Alright. Then we have to find the next one. It increases maximum health. Codex found. So they want me to sprint all around this place and find this stuff? I really don't want to do that. Ah, there we go. Should be something like that. Nope. I already examined that. Let me see. Huh. My bad, buddy. Okay, there we go.
Looks rather risky, really.
All right, so let's collect these. All right, there's the next one. Yay! Come on. Wait a sec.
Careful, please, John.
My lady, don't be so mean. Ooh. Yeah. That's right. I'm freaking athletic, son. Huh.
Has he been drinking?
Okay, where's the last codex? And don't worry, this is the stuff I'm not going to be doing. The only thing that I will be doing is, like, upgrading weapons and looking at viewpoints. That's the only thing I'm going to be doing. I'm not gonna gather these codexes and stuff like that. I might rip off like a few couple papers, you know, so I'm not noticed. But I'm not gonna do all this crap. What is that thing there? What is that? Is that it? What in the world is this thing? Mars, a simulated statues. So this is statues you gotta find and put on there, but I am not doing that. You know, I think I know a better way. I can find a way to get these things. Here, what if I look on my map? Aha! Okay. See that? Maps are wonderful things, aren't they? Alright, we're gonna get a horse. Then we're gonna go all the way there. Whoa, buddy! So, that's what we're gonna do. Alright, there we go. Alright. Ho! Get out of here. All right. There we go.
Hey, hey.
The eight sons, whatever that means. Okay. Memory sequence 3 complete. Okay. Alright, I gotta find a way to get back.
Yeah.
See how much time I wasted? Didn't want to waste any of that time. Right in his face. I love that. Okay, let's see. Who are we talking to here? Do we go this way? No, not Maria. What's up here? Okay, I'm getting off track though. Let's go back down.
Salute, Claudia.
Our uncle is un mostro. This is outrageous.
What's happened?
He's making me work. If Father was here, I'd never be stuck behind a desk like this.
And what are the terms of this supported enslavement?
Since someone decided we're going to stay here, Tio Mario suggested we try and find the money to repair the villa. Problem is, there isn't any.
I bet I can bring in some money.
Oh, great. More work for me.
Oh, great. And more work for me.
Improvements to the town, I'll keep track of them in this book. And since I have nothing better to do, I'll also make note of any objects you bring in from the outside. If you actually get this place up and running, travelers might visit and spend money. Although I doubt anyone will want to come this far out of the city. But if they do, I'll keep the money we make in this chest. You're going to have to show up to take it to the bank yourself. Because when it gets full, I'm just going to take the extra cash for myself. Capito?
Deal.
I think that means capiche. What in the world? Oh, is that what all the... No! Okay. Ain't no way I'm doing that. Okay.
Buongiorno. Is there something wrong?
Yes, Sir Mario hired me to deal with this mess, but I'm an architetto, not a miracle worker. Without money, I can't fix any of these buildings.
And if someone brought you money?
Then we'd be in business. You must be Sir Ezio. Am I right?
Uncle, I like this architetto.
He gets very observant when he can smell money.
If you want to fix up this town, I'm going to need it. I have a price list here for new shops and renovations. Just bring me gold, make a choice, and I'll begin at once. If I build you a shop, you, as the landlord, can purchase goods there at lower rates. If you invest more money in the shop, you get an even greater discount. As for renovations, well, you'll be bringing the town and villa back to life. As Sir Mario tells me, that was very important to your great-great-grandfather. Plus, when you buy shops and renovations, you'll be increasing the number of people who visit, causing your income to increase. So, let's take a look, shall we?
Oh, so I just have to... Actually, in a way, that might be good. Mines. A church. Military barracks. Oh! I see, this is cool. Whoa. This is actually pretty cool. Military barracks, so I'll have like better military or something like that. Okay, so what I'll do is I'm gonna do these small ones first. First, I'm gonna start the military barracks. Yep, we've just confirmed reservations on that. So that one is good. Our military barracks, there we go. And then, Thieves Guild, a well, the city's value, okay, church, renovating a church will increase, but a brothel, mines, okay, let's see, yeah, let's do a Thieves Guild. Awesome. I thought this was going to be a whole bunch of huge work, but I can do this. So it seems like every dude I eliminate, I'm going to have to just pour in here.
Buon viaggio.
So anyway, hey, that's not so bad. I'll probably do that, but this crap with Claudia, I don't know. You know, I might, you know. I can't just only do campaign, so who knows. But I'm going to try.
My boy, I think it's time I showed you something.
Okay. What is down here? Whoa. Okay, let's speak to him then.
This is the sanctuary. It was built by my great-grandfather to honor the memory of the Assassin Order and protect its secrets. Look around. These are the assassins who guarded the freedom of humanity when it was most threatened. And this is the armor of Altair. Little is known Altair. About Altair's life, but his armor is light and very strong. I give it to you. But I don't know how to retrieve it. My great-grandfather told me it would remain locked away until all its protectors were made whole. I heard rumors of crypts located throughout Italia. Hidden tombs filled with treasure, where these six were moved centuries ago. Maybe they have something to do with it. In my younger days, I sought the six myself, with no success. Perhaps you will have better luck.
Perhaps I will.
In order to achieve perfect synchronization with Ezio, you have to get that armor.
Okay, how am I gonna do that? Oh, he shot Genghis Khan's horse? He used the bow and arrow to shoot Genghis Khan's horse. Whoa, that's cool! Top this pedestal stands the statue of Darius, the male Persian assassin. He used his hidden blade to kill Xerxes. This was the first recorded use of the hidden blade. It looks like something is missing from the pedestal. Whoa! That's awesome! Atop this pedestal stands a statue of Wei Hu, the male Chinese assassin. He used the spear to kill the Chinese emperor Qing Shang Hung. It looks like something is missing in the pedestal. Okay! Well, that's tight. Alright. Alright. The Anumit. She killed Cleopatra with a snake. Jeez. Assassinating all the important people, huh? Alright. And she poisoned At least now we know what happened to Alexander. Alright, atop a female Babylonian assassin. Looks like something is missing from the pedestal. Jeez! Alright, Lyons. Caliglia. He stabbed him. He stabbed a Roman emperor. My goodness. Such violent people. What am I talking about? Jeez, but that's awesome though! So it started a long time ago. So Altair wasn't the first assassin then. I have a theory about that. Okay. Alright, we're gonna get out of here. Actually, let's see. Let's see on the map. We're gonna head back to Florence. It seems. But it seems like we're gonna have to stop here, guys. That was pretty interesting to see about how the assassins, you know, how long, or not how long, but how early it started. You know, that's cool, right? Anyway. So guys, I'll see you guys next time. If you guys wanna hit me up and know what's going on my YouTube channel, just like me on Instagram and hit me up on Twitter. And if you want to know what's going up on my YouTube channel, just like and subscribe on my YouTube channel as well too. And I'll see you guys next time.